Ladies and gentlemen, and members of the press, I greet you and welcome you to this press conference. My name is Luis Lobong Lojore, and beside me is a part of members of my family who happen to be in Juba here. Madam Netta is my elder wife, and the rest are my children. So we represent the family of Lojore, as you might have seen in the invitation. I would like to appreciate and thank you very much for coming. And we are going to be very brief. My first reads, Lojore family are not involved in the mining sector of South Sudan. A response to the Sentry and Untapped and Unprepared reports, which was in April. On April the 2nd, 2020, the Sentry published a critical report entitled Untapped and Unprepared Dirty Deals Threaten South Sudan Mining Sector. This work examines the mining industry in our war-torn country. The results allege the capture of the South Sudan mining sector by the country elites. A vast majority current and the former government officials and their families. That's what the report said. The report continued. The report referenced an army of mining companies linked to the families of President Salva Kiir Mayardit, the Vice President James Wanyika, General Malik Rubin, General Paul Malongawan, Dr. Peter Adok Nyamba, and General Luis Lobong Lojore. In other reports of the century, other South Sudanese leaders, the Sentry is accused of a similar offense, includes James Hos Mike, General Colma Nyamajuk, General Obote Mamour, His Excellency Dr. Riak Machar, Ambassador Isaac Lual, General Jok Riak, among others. This floundering of the mining resources by the public officials and their network, according to the Sentry, is aided by legions of unscrupulous global investors who bankroll some of the South Sudanese corporate agents, even from companies registry at the South Sudan Ministry of Justice. He is presented a listing shareholders for 11 mining inventions. Our response. The intention of the Sentry is to jeopardize South Sudan future by destroying its leaders' reputations, setting the country up for an international bank neocolonialism. I repeat, the intention, according to us, of the Sentry is to destroy its leaders, South Sudanese leaders' reputations, setting up the country up for an international bank neocolonialism. As leaders of the country, We must face these destructive forces through presentation of facts and legislation. To produce a response and input into the lawsuit, our family plan. We evaluate all the allegations by collecting information from many sources. I present what we found in this press statement. Lojore family has taken note of such gross accusation. The reason for this response is an attempt to clear its name. We state and onset that Lojore family is not involved in the South Sudan mining sector. In the states, the family has two major assets, both registered according to the law of the country. This includes the livestock and hotel industry, particularly a hotel called Kuleo, both located in Kapoete town. This press is intended to refute such allegations as follows. The Sentry alleged that Lojore family owned a house both using resources from mineral extractions. This is not true. Acquired in 2011, the house is a property of a Diamond Trust Bank, DTB, based in Kenya. And it is being paid for through mortgage loans. Transaction from our family indicates periodic payment to the developer and the bank. At some point, the family could not afford to make regular payment, and the house was almost foreclosed. The family received two eviction notices in the last 2 years alone, which we present in the reports. I'm sure you have got the report. You will see how we acquired the house, how we have been paying installment, and up to date, we have not completed. So the house still belongs to the property of the bank until we complete the payment. Mrs. Natalina, her name is also written wrongly in a Sentry report, but we put the way it is. Is my wife, she's the one here. According to our finding, we found she is a shareholder of the World Focus International, owned by Romana Lema Mokaya, an Ethiopian citizen. According to the business report registry. But her name, the name of Natalina, was added to the company to meet the requirement of South Sudan Companies Registration Act. The family found out that the owner of the company signed the memo of association on Natalina's behalf. You will also see in the report. It is not her signature, that lady signed on her behalf. World Focus never undertook a field operation, partly because it lacked resources and partly because it is not registered with the Ministry of Mining. Mrs. Samira Ayen, who is also my wife, we found that she sits on the board of Goldstone. which is owned by Solomon Wolf, an Israeli investor. The company was registered by the Ministry of Justice in August 2015. Application for a company bank account to which $1 million, which amount to 100% shares, was supposed to be deposited by Mr. Wolf was filed in May 2016. Mr. Wolf left Ufa for Israel, supposedly executes a financial transfer to commence his company operation. Unfortunately, the conflict broke out in Juba 2016, leading to the suspension of the company operation plan. Mr. Wolf never returned to South Sudan to date. The mining license expired and was not renewed. You can just see the two did not do anything, they just registration. Goldstone is solely owned by Mr. Wolf. The memo written by the Nile Basin advocates states that Mr. Solmo Wolf shall be the only registrar to the account. It read that Mr. Solmo Mr. Solomon Wolf shall be the only registrar to the accounts for the bank or banking instrument and shall sign the bank instrument alone. This is a document from the advocate, which means Solomon was the sole owner of the company. And the rest were just put for the sake of registration according to the South Sudan law. A memo from a certain director, Daniel Taman, grants the powers of the attorney to Solomon Wolf to act as the legal authorized representative of the company. We are quoting the evidence that shows, that will tell you, my wife, even if my her name appeared there, was not really involved in the mining. The laws of South Sudan require that a foreign investor grants 31% shares in the venture to the national. Although Article 323, sub-Article 5, stipulates that the financially able South Sudanese are entitled to these shares, it does not specify the amount of shareholders is supposed to make. This has resulted in the foreign investors co-opting South Sudanese only to meet their basic requirement, lending the local shareholders a symbolic participation. As such, a vast majority of South Sudanese shareholders do not often participate in the management of the profit of the company, the case for the Goldstone present. It's also an offer for us all South Sudanese, as if foreign companies are only using us to achieve their interests. At the end of the day, we are implicated. The registration of the companies linked to corruption in the mining sector varies between 2007 and 2016. The majority registered before the eruption of the 2013 conflict, information from armed conflict location, events, data, some report a clear, does not support this assumption. Eastern Equatoria is more peaceful than, say, Central Equatoria, as the number of the conflict has been declining since 2007. So there are no mineral-related conflict in Eastern Equatoria at the Sentry at large. The Sentry indexed its victims, or charged, or crucified its victims using associations, consequently dragging General Louis Lobong into the present report. Therefore, General Louis Lobong Lojore, as individual citizen, should not be accused or held accountable for the crime his adult relatives might commit or have committed. As you can see, these are part of my family. They are all grown up. They are mature. And I think by law, they are allowed to do, they can do, seek for a job and do business. If I told they are doing business, why should I be held responsible of the act? As even the above indicates, the Jure family own a business in the hotel industry and a live store in Kapoeta. It is not involved in the mining sector. That is, in Equatorial communities and conflicting over mining resources is politically assumed. Available statistic evidence shows Eastern Equatoria is more peaceful than Central Equatoria, just for example. But General Louis Lobong, who is the Sentry target, is a historical leader of the SPLM with immense integrity. The Sentry judge charged General Louis Lobong on the basis of familial connection, amounting to political witch hunt. This is why the Sentry believe he should be held accountable for the crime his adult relatives are alleged to have committed. The Sentry intention is clear: defame South Sudanese leaders in order to collide them with the citizen, an international community, rendering the country volatile, ungovernable. What the Sentry intend to achieve with the destructive objectives, however, is not clear to our family. We would like to say to the world, the people of South Sudan, the people of Eastern Equatoria, and the family friends of Lojore, that Lojore family have never committed any wrongdoing. As such, we are ready to pursue this case against the Sentry before the court of public opinion and the court of justice to clear our family name. With this, I will end here. And I thank you very much for listening, and I'm ready for any clarification or any question. The report is already with you. This is just a summary. And again, what you see there, because we do not want your bulk report, there are so many evidence. We just picked some, including the one for payment of the hours. We just picked very few. Let me begin with your last question. I will look where there is justice. If there is justice is standing up, I will go and will travel to reach up and sue them and seek justice there. If it is in America, I will go. If it is UK or where, I will go. That is the answer of the last question. The second question, that is true. The report came in April. the second. And I was in my village where there are no even a network. I came to learn it very late. And then I was cut off in Capoeira because the Corona Task Force have suspended the movement. Again, and it is not easy to assemble this report, to get what happened, exactly what is happening in different ministries here. This is another thing that took a time. So, and again, requesting and trying to get document from Kenya for the issue of the house. This document is to come all the way from Kenya. And therefore, it will also take time. And I believe it is not late. Thank you very much, Mr. Alardo. I don't know the Sentry. I've been reading various reports about the Sentry. I even didn't know where they. But I came and I was thinking maybe they have evidence of the people that they have been accusing. But when it reached to me, and I know about myself, I have now come to believe that. Then it is possible the rest I have also mentioned here will also be a victim just like me. But as I will say, I'm not speaking on their behalf. I'm not authorized to speak on behalf. I'm just giving an example. I believe there are so many thousands, hundreds, if not thousands, of South Sudanese women and men who are involved in business. And now, why only relatives of prominent politicians and have been connected with the politician rather than mentioning their names? Then there's something fishy about it. That's why I mentioned them. The last question was what?
I was saying, why do you think this is behind this? Who is behind it?
Okay. To me, I think the dysentery report, this group, are using a buying report, buying a false report from other South Sudanese people. And probably it could be the people who are opponent to other political leaders here. This is my assumption. But again, if they were to get the correct evidence, that would be good. But I think they buy a false report, which is not having essentially evidence. I think I have mentioned here that it is time for the leaders or the government of South Sudan or the leaders of political leaders of South Sudan to get up, to work up. I have been hearing these things long. People are sanctioned. As I said, maybe I was assuming that this will have some evidence. I have now come to believe that there might be something well planned somewhere. Really to target the people, the leaders of South Sudan, and make this country ungovernable. And that's why I said here, the leaders must get up and the government of South Sudan must get up to fight these evil forces. And we are not fighting with a gun, but rather let us fight through through justice. And we must provide evidence. And I believe there is justice somewhere, if it is not in another country, but maybe in other countries. And we must fight to get these people to bring to books. Well, I cannot speak on behalf of everybody. Let me speak on my behalf. Maybe you're talking about the house that I am, the one I've been accused in Nairobi. In that house, it's simply because my children are studying there. As soon as they finish, I will even sell that house and I will bring the money here.